everybody's attention. Now that we've taken care of some of the logistics, I'm glad the house filled up. We want to be embarrassed for having international guests and nobody to welcome. So we have a warm welcome for the delegation from Federation of Cuban Women. National Federation, right?
Let me just introduce the invited guests here tonight from Cuba. They are part of a broader delegation representing Cuba at a UN conference on the status of women that takes place every year. This is the 59th session. And so some of their members, it's a full-time agenda, but we have three members of the Cuban delegation here tonight, and they just spoke. Just came from Essex County College, and we have Lázaro Castillo from the Union of Cuban Union of Writers and Artists of Cuba. Maritzel Gonzalez from the Federation of Cuban Women of the International Relations Department. And we have Ana Milagro Martinez, who's a member of another Cuban organization, the Cuban Association of the United Nations.
Good evening. Well, as Martin says, we are part of the Cuban delegation that participated in the 59th Commission of the Status of Women. Our delegation is integrated by the 10 peoples. So here is part of them. Well, my name is Maritzel Gonzalez, and I am a member of the Federation of Cuban Women as Ana Milagros, but Lázaro, he is not a member of the organization, of women organization.
Like
he's a friend of our organization.
He's okay? Feminist.
Because he defends his struggle also for the women's rights. Well, we are very glad tonight to stay here in this solidarity space and to share with people who, in my opinion, people who knows about our country, about Cuba, and also people who love our socialism, who love our system, who love a humanity country. My English is not so good. I try to explain you something, but
I'm sorry.
Mucho calor.
In our country, we always have a huge respect for people who defend their rights, for people to defend their thinking, and also who are solidarity with our country. My organization is a very huge organization in Cuba. It is a mass organization that are group more than 4 million women. So it represents 90% of women population 14 years old and beyond. We are a very, this organization was created in 1960. So it means 1 year before after the Cuban Revolution, the triumph of the Cuban Revolution in 1959. Before 1959, Cuban women were discriminated based in, I mean, they are discriminated because of they are women, maybe because of they are poor women, and also in a case of because they are black women. And they were subjected to a different kind of discrimination. After the Cuban Revolution, women face another spaces. They face, I mean, they may do anything. They may participate in the programs that the government development in order to all of society may participate in this program. For example, for me, one of the most important program after the 1959 was the literacy campaign. Because many Cuban people were illiterate. And through this campaign, women and men, and also young people, participated in that campaign. It was in 1961. And in only 1 year, all Cuban people were
learn to read and write.
Learn how to read and write. So they wake up. I say they wake up because they were sleeping. If they know how to learn and write, they wake up. And for us, it was one of the first important programs. After that, the whole population continue their studies until nowadays that, for example, women represent at about 63% of the graduated at the university. It wasn't impossible before 1959. So it is only possible because of the Cuban Revolution was so
justice, so
humanity, in order that all people participated in their Cuban, I mean, in their programs, in their social programs. But now, I will pass the word
to me,
one of my friends.
Dear friends, women and men, for us, it's a great honor to share with you just a little bit of your time, to share with you solidarity with People's Organization for Progress. I know the great work you're doing, and take it for sure that the Cuban people is supporting you, although there are many media campaigns against Cuba. For us, this kind of interchange is crucial to build links and relationship among our peoples. We always say that the US government is bad, sorry. But I know, but the people is great. The people is wonderful for us, and there are many beautiful faces that are join us this night, and it is a proof that we both peoples can work together, can live together in peace, with respect, with a lot of respect. That's what Cuba asks for, respect to our independence, to our social project, to our sovereignty. We won't allow any government to interfere in our domestic problems. We do have our problems, and this is a challenge for the Cuban people to solve this problem, and it is a challenge for the US people to solve your problems. And this is what we ask for, respect. And every people have the right to choose the way they want to go with the people. And Cuba has elected socialism. We are building socialism. We are building a new project, and we ask for respect because we respect any people of the world. We cannot invade any people, any country, and that's why we are against terrorism. And we ask for lifting Cuba from the list of countries that host terrorism. We ask all the people of the world that respect Cuba and join us in the struggle against blockade. That's why we thank you very much for hosting us this night, for giving us the opportunity to be a little bit more closer to you, to US people, to very simple people, the people we love. Thank you very much.
Muy buenas noches.
Good evening.
Gracias por abrirnos las puertas y recibirnos y regalarnos este tiempo.
Thank you for opening your doors to us and welcoming us.
De veras,
and giving us your time.
De veras me siento muy emocionado.
I truly feel moved.
Yo soy poeta y los poetas nos manifestamos de esa manera.
I'm a poet and we poets express ourselves this way.
Porque somos muy somos tocados sobre todo por el espíritu. Tocados por el espíritu.
Sentimos. We're always touched in our souls.
Represento una organización social en Cuba.
I represent a social organization in Cuba.
En el evento en que mis colegas están acá también.
And
at
I'm attending the event, the same event that my colleagues are participating in.
Que es la Unión de Escritores y Artistas de Cuba.
And my organization is the Cuban Union of Writers and Artists.
Que surgimos en el año 1991.
Which was born in 1961.
Ya casi cerca de 54 años.
And has been active now for 54 years.
Y surge a partir del espíritu y la idea de nuestro comandante en jefe Fidel Castro.
And was born out of the spirit and the ideas of our commander-in-chief, Fidel Castro.
En su encuentro con los intelectuales a inicios de la revolución.
In his meeting with the country's intellectuals at the beginning of the revolution.
Y surge la idea de crear esta organización que reúne a escritores y artistas de todas las manifestaciones.
And out of that meeting, the idea came of forming this organization of writers and artists across the country.
Para apoyar
different aspects of art and culture.
Para apoyar y crecer en el pensamiento cultural de nuestra revolución.
To support and develop the development of culture in our revolution.
O sea que inicia ahí nuestro apoyo de la política cultural a partir de esas palabras entre el comandante en jefe.
And out of that came our policy of supporting the cultural policy of our
le expresa a los artistas y intelectuales de ese momento.
Where he expressed the support for artists and writers.
Inicialmente nació en La Habana.
It emerged first in Havana.
Donde se reunían los grandes artistas intelectuales.
Where many of the great artists and intellectuals in Cuba were based.
Y con los años fue creciendo y existe sedes en todas las provincias y municipios y algunos municipios del país.
The organization ONIAC continued to expand and now exists in all the provinces and many of the municipalities, most of the municipalities in Cuba.
Es una organización selectiva.
Our organization has a selective character.
Porque lo primordial es la calidad de la obra de los escritores y artistas a la hora de entrar a esa organización.
Because it is based on the quality of having a record of artistic work on becoming members of the organization.
Eso no quiere decir que con nuestra obra no influyamos en la sociedad cubana.
That doesn't mean that we don't dedicate ourselves to use our art to influence, to contribute to society.
Porque la unidad, que es como la llamamos, la integran escritores, pero músicos.
UNIAC is made up of writers, but also musicians.
¿Y cuánto nos pueden transmitir los músicos desde valores y sobre todo desde nuestra salvaguarda de nuestra identidad?
And like writers, musicians too can also transmit values, our values, of our identity.
Y para que nuestros géneros musicales no se pierdan, que nacieron en Cuba.
To make sure not to lose the musical genres that come out of, that are native to our country.
Independientemente que han sido permeados de muchas otras culturas.
Without denying the fact that our music and culture has been permeated by those of other countries.
Sobre todo de la música africana y también de la música incluso norteamericana.
Especially African culture, African music and from North America.
Pero tenemos los realizadores y realizadoras del cine y la televisión.
But we have artists that work in film and television.
¿Qué cuánto no aportan con su obra a la formación incluso de los jóvenes y no tan jóvenes que puedan disfrutar del arte en nuestra nación?
And they too help educate young people and not so young people in our country.
Desde el escultor, el artista plástico.
That the same is true of sculptors and other artists.
El actor, la actriz.
Actors,
o sea, ¿cuánto no pueden aportar?
Can all contribute to this.
Nosotros no hemos encontrado ninguna organización en el mundo que se parezca a la nuestra.
We haven't found any organization in the world that is like ours.
Porque es muy amplia y reúne, o sea, todos los escritores y artistas en el mundo nos hemos encontrado.
Because it's very broad and includes all our writers and artists in our country.
Organizaciones similares, pero en las artes plásticas.
In other parts of the world, we found similar organizations, but they only organize artists and sculptors.
En el cine.
Or people working in film.
O sociedades de escritores, pero
or
no.
Or societies, associations of writers.
Pero no una que una a tantas manifestaciones.
But not one that brings together all the different artistic expressions.
Es un placer tremendo poder compartir con ustedes este rato.
It's a tremendous pleasure for us to be able to share this moment with you.
Hablar desde nuestra experiencia.
And to talk about our experience.
Yo, por ejemplo, soy de origen muy humilde.
I come from a very humble background.
De campesinos.
I come from a farm background.
Del norte de la provincia de Santi Spíritus.
From the north part of Santi Spíritus province.
Y también hijo de un combatiente.
And I'm also the son of a combatant.
De la columna de Camilo Cienfuegos.
My father was a combatant in the rebel army column led by Camilo Cienfuegos.
Eso es algo que siempre desde la familia es muy importante en la formación de uno como ciudadano cubano.
That experience is very important in that influence in the family and the development of Cuban citizens.
Porque todos nuestros familiares han tenido acceso incluso a la cultura.
Because all our family members have had access to this kind of culture.
A la educación.
To education.
A la salud y ha sido gratuito.
To healthcare, that all of which is free.
Me hice licenciado en literatura. Después hice también incluso una maestría en cultura y arte latinoamericano y no me costó un centavo.
I graduated, I got a degree in literature and in Latin American art and culture, and it didn't cost me a cent.
Solo lo que yo podía aportar.
It only cost me what I was able to contribute.
Solo lo que podría aportar desde mi, o sea, mi conciencia de estudiar y ser cada vez
my mucho consciousness
más.
And ability to study.
Es solo un ejemplo, pero así vive incluso nuestra sociedad cubana.
I'm just giving you my personal example, but that's true throughout Cuban society.
De los derechos que incluso tienen nuestras mujeres.
About the rights that we have, especially including women.
En Unión de Escritores y Artistas tenemos incluso el 44% de mujeres que son artistas y miembros.
My organization, UNIAC, 44% of the artists are women.
Y el 40% nos place que sea también dirigente y nos dirigen las mujeres.
And we're very happy that 40% of our leaders are women and lead us.
Porque son muy inteligentes y contribuyen también a esa sensibilidad y a ese cariño de hacer las cosas.
They are very intelligent and contribute to that sensitivity in about doing things.
Gracias.
Sensitivity and affection.
Gracias y espero que se pregunte.
So thank you and we're ready for your questions.
About the so-called normalization between America and Cuba.
¿Qué piensan de la supuesta normalización de relaciones entre Estados Unidos y Cuba?
Respondo.
I think the question was, what do you think about the so-called normalization of relations between the United States and Cuba?
Yes.
He's suggesting that maybe you could take two or three questions and then take them up.
Anybody else want to have a question? Brother.
Can you briefly discuss the role of UNIAC a few years ago in the fight against the fight against racism?
Cómo enfrentar
¿cómo es?
La unión
de la frente al racismo. Sobre todo hace unos años
tenemos
en
tenemos una comisión.
Another question, sister.
In relation to the first question, I would like to see how people in Cuba are reacting to this. And you know, different groups of people, I'm sure, they have different reactions to normalization.
The normalization.
In December, the last three of the Cuban Five who were in prison were released. Could you tell us a little bit about, they were in prison for 16 years, but what Cuba did to make it possible with its support around the world to free them from prison?
Pero que quiere en un comentario,
sí,
¿no?
Sí.
¿Cuál fue la reacción del pueblo cubano y cómo se logró eso?
Que eso es parte de...
Eso
es parte de la reacción del pueblo.
Hold on, we'll answer these and then come back.
Very briefly. 100% of the Cuban people is for the good relations between U.S. and Cuba. We can assure that. But certainly, they have had already two rounds of dialogues between our governments, and it is very important to point out that we have a lot of expectations, but we must be realistic. And in that sense, we are very realistic. And we should see this as a historic momentum, but we cannot forget that there are some facts. First of all, Cuba is in the list of terrorist countries. The list that United States unilaterally always has taken this as something very natural. No one, no other government in the world does that. First, the lifting of the Cuba from this list is essential. It's a prerequisite. Number two, there is a blockade. The blockade is a policy that it's maintained during more than 50 years against the will of the whole international community. Let's remember that for more than 20 years, the United Nations has passed and with the majority of the governments, with the support of the majority of the governments, the resolution to put an end to blockade. The United States is against that resolution and doesn't do anything on that. With blockade, no normalization of the relationships. We are aware of this. Then we have Guantanamo. The problem of Guantanamo is something that hurts Cuban people a lot. There is a jail. This is a criminal situation that is happening in Guantanamo. And everybody knows about that. What to do? This is a Cuban territory that belongs to the people. Why is United States in Guantanamo? And then something that I think and I believe the government of Obama is very aware of the fact that this dialogue must be based on respect to our system, in respect to our sovereignty, in respect of our independence, in respect on our role in the world. Don't forget that thousands of doctors and nurses from Cuba are working in more than 100 countries of the world. And this is a result of our system, that it is not perfect. Of course, we have a lot of challenges, but those doctors that are working abroad belong to a poor people, to a poor people that gives the best to other peoples of the world, health. Since in Cuba our health is free and universal, we are defending the right to health, the right to education, the right to a liberty from our point of view.
To be a human being.
To be a real human being. And there are some things that the United States, I mean the government, because we always make a distinction between the government and the people. The government of the United States should be aware of that we won't have any result without with these facts that are interfering in this dialogue. We won't forget that the mission in Washington cannot make any arrangement because of the financial obstacles that the government of the United States is putting and is pressing. So put all this out and then we will have a good relationship. We are, of course, 100% because we are a poor country, but we are open to the world. We are open to any friend that would like to see Cuba with good eyes, because there are good eyes and bad eyes. And certainly, we are for the good relationships. We are for the normalization of the relations, diplomatic relationships, but on this basis. So we have a lot of expectation, but let's see how things are going on. That's what we can say. We are 100%. All the people of Cuba is for the normalization of the relationship. We don't need any poll. We don't need any question. It's something that we believe that we are, you know, very proud of being friend of the US people. We have many facts that talk about that. And many friends that are here that have come to Cuba, they always receive solidarity, they always receive friendship, they always receive love. And that's what we want for your people and for our people. Thank you.
Bueno, voy a hablar en español.
Well, I'm going to speak in Spanish.
Con relación a la reacción de nuestro pueblo después de las intervenciones del presidente, de nuestro presidente Raúl Castro y del presidente de los Estados Unidos Barack Obama.
Regarding the reaction of our people after the speeches given by the U.S. President Barack Obama and our President Raúl Castro.
Les puedo asegurar que la reacción del pueblo fue con mucha dignidad.
The reaction of our people was one of great dignity.
Yo recuerdo ese momento del 17 de diciembre.
I remember that moment on December 17th.
Estábamos trabajando en la sede nacional de la Federación, que es nuestro lugar de trabajo.
We were working at the headquarters of the Federation of Cuban Women, where we work.
Y amistades nuestras nos llamaron por teléfono, familiares.
Our friends and relatives began calling us on the phone.
Y nos anunciaron a las 12 van a hablar los presidentes de Cuba y de Estados Unidos.
And they said at 12 o'clock noon, the presidents of Cuba and the United States are going to be speaking on television.
Por supuesto, no sabíamos de qué se trataba.
Of course, we didn't know what it was about.
Y todas estábamos preocupadas.
We were all worried.
Alguien hablaba de la libertad de los cinco.
Some people were talking about the release of the Cuban Five.
Y bueno, ¿y qué pasó, no?
And so what happened?
Y entonces, como somos tan espontáneos,
since we're so
porque eso es por naturaleza,
that's our
rápidamente apareció un televisor.
Very quickly, a television materialized.
En el área donde se almuerza en la sede nacional.
In the lunchroom at the Federation.
Se agruparon allí todos los trabajadores de la sede nacional.
All the workers at the headquarters came together.
Es decir, compartimos ese momento tanto los funcionarios de la sede como los trabajadores administrativos, como los choferes, la cocinera, es decir, todos nuestros trabajadores.
We all came together and shared this moment, the officials, the administrative workers, the cooks, the chauffeurs,
y
the drivers.
Comenzamos a escuchar a nuestro presidente Raúl Castro.
And we began to hear our president, Raúl Castro.
Lo único que nosotros escuchamos fue cuando él expresó que los tres hermanos que nos quedaban del lado de acá estaban aterrizando en el aeropuerto cubano.
The only thing we heard was his words saying that our three brothers who were remaining on this side had landed in Cuba.
Porque lo que él habló después, yo creo que nadie en el país lo escuchó.
Because I think that everything that was said after that, no one in the country heard it.
Después me enteré que en la Asamblea Nacional sucedió lo mismo.
Then later I found out that in the National Assembly the same thing happened.
Es decir, estaba sesionando la Asamblea Nacional.
The National Assembly was,
cuando dan la noticia.
In session when the news came out.
Miren, la alegría fue tan grande
the happiness, the joy was so great,
que salimos corriendo a buscar una bandera cubana.
We went running to find a Cuban flag.
Y ya íbamos para la calle, ¿no?
And we went out on the street.
Y nos dijeron, no, que hay que trabajar.
And they told us, no, you have to work.
Nos sustituyeron los jóvenes universitarios.
We were replaced by the university students.
Ellos sí salieron para la calle.
They went out on the street.
Yo creo que todo el pueblo cubano,
I think the entire Cuban people,
estaba muy alegre y muy contento por el regreso de nuestros tres hermanos.
Was very happy about the return of our three brothers.
Después fue que nos enteramos del anuncio de comenzar los diálogos entre Cuba y Estados Unidos.
Later we heard about the announcement of the beginning of the dialogue between the two countries.
Pienso que es una oportunidad única.
I think it's a unique opportunity
que tienen nuestros dos países
that our two countries have
para comenzar un diálogo.
To begin a dialogue.
Un diálogo que hasta el momento ha sido muy respetuoso.
A dialogue that so far has been very respectful.
Por ambas partes.
On both sides.
Un diálogo donde ha estado siempre presente la igualdad, es decir, las posiciones de igualdad.
A dialogue where an equality of positions has been maintained always.
Y eso para nosotros es importante.
Which for us is very important.
Porque por primera vez en 56 años que tiene ya la Revolución Cubana,
because for the first time in the 56 years of the Cuban Revolution,
el gobierno de Estados Unidos ha reconocido que fue un error la política de este gobierno hacia Cuba.
Because for the very first time, the U.S. government recognized that it was an error to have this policy towards the Cuban Revolution.
Esa política de aislamiento,
the policy of isolation,
esa política de bloqueo,
of blockade,
o sea, ha sido reconocida en todos los medios internacionales de que fue un error.
In all the international forums, arenas, it's been recognized to be an error.
Y que fracasó.
And that it failed.
Y nos piden sentarnos de igual a igual.
And we're asked to sit down as equals.
Y lo más interesante de estas conversaciones es que están siendo protagonizadas por dos mujeres.
And it's interesting that these talks are being led by two women.
Una mujer por la parte de los Estados Unidos.
A woman from the United States.
Y una mujer por la parte cubana.
And a woman representing Cuba.
O sea que es reconocido el papel de la mujer en estos diálogos.
So the role of women has been recognized in these discussions.
¿Quién hubiera pensado hace 20, 30 años atrás que esto podría haber sucedido?
20 or 30 years
y de esta manera.
That was possible in this
un año atrás.
Yo creo que ni un año ni dos atrás.
Maybe even one or two years ago.
Pero bueno, la reacción ha sido muy positiva.
But the reaction has been very positive.
El recibimiento de los tres hermanos ha sido espectacular.
The welcoming of our three brothers has been spectacular.
Yo creo que ellos no han podido tener tiempo ni siquiera de descansar.
I don't think they've even had time to rest.
Porque su primera actividad pública fue precisamente un concierto con Silvio Rodríguez.
Their very first public activity was being at a concert by Silvio Rodríguez, the musician.
No sé si aquí lo pudieron haber visto.
I don't know if maybe you were able to see it.
Fue algo extraordinario.
It was extraordinary.
En un parqueo de un estadio de béisbol.
In a baseball parking stadium, a baseball stadium parking lot.
Con la población de ese municipio y de todos los municipios cercanos.
With the turnout being the whole population of that neighborhood and all the surrounding neighborhoods.
Y la participación activa de los cinco.
And the active participation of the five.
Ninguno de ellos es cantante.
None of them is a singer.
Y ese día los cinco cantaban.
And that day all five of them sang.
Y decían que el que estaba desafinado era Silvio Rodríguez.
And they said the one who was out of tune was Silvio Rodríguez.
Yo creo que eso, vaya, la verdad, ha sido fenomenal. Y el recibimiento del pueblo cubano con ellos es fantástico.
And the welcoming by the Cuban people was fantastic.
Todo el mundo quiere tenerlos.
Everyone wants to have them.
A veces
there.
Se tienen que dividir.
Now, sometimes they have to divide up on where they go.
Pero donde quiera que llegan, tienen el respeto y la admiración de nuestro pueblo.
But wherever they go, they have the respect and admiration of our people.
Y yo creo que en este recibimiento y esta alegría que compartimos los cubanos y cubanas,
welcoming and the joy shared by Cubans,
Hay una parte del pueblo norteamericano también.
There's a part of the American people that are part of this too.
Aquellas personas de este pueblo que también han contribuido con que este hecho se haya hecho realidad.
Those people here in this country who contributed to that victory.
Y creo que aquí en este salón hay algunos de ellos.
And I think in this room there are some of you here.
Le agradecemos eternamente.
We are eternally grateful to you.
Esa solidaridad tan abierta, tan espontánea.
For that open and spontaneous solidarity from you.
Tan libre.
So free.
Y comprometida.
And committed.
Con nuestro pueblo y nuestra sociedad. Y
with,
nuestra revolución.
With our people and our society and our revolution.
Yeah. Sobre todo mi pregunta es cómo la UNIAC enfrenta el tema del racismo.
To take up the question of how the UNIAC is taking up the question of racism.
Una de las primeras organizaciones que ha trabajado esta temática ha sido la UNIAC, por supuesto.
UNIAC has been one of the very first organizations to take on this question.
En la propia organización tenemos una comisión que trabaja permanentemente que se llama. ¿Sí?
In UNIAC we have a commission that works on a permanent basis.
¿Qué es la comisión José Antonio Aponte?
On this question, it's called the José Antonio Aponte Commission.
Sí, en honor a un líder. Negro asesinado en Cuba.
In honor of a black leader who was murdered in Cuba.
Hace muchos años.
Assassinated many years ago.
Antes que triunfara la revolución.
Before the victory of the revolution.
La revolución cubana.
Before the victory of the Cuban Revolution.
Son temas que incluso trabajamos a diario.
These are questions that we take on, discuss on a daily basis.
Y mensualmente, incluso la comisión se reúne con el primer vicepresidente del país.
Our commission meets on a monthly basis with the first vice president of Cuba.
Para darle tratamiento a la estrategia y seguimiento sobre todo.
To discuss the strategy and especially the follow-up continuing work.
Para que no quede suelto ningún punto.
To make sure there's no point that's left
unaddressed. A la vez, trabajamos incluso con el Instituto Cubano de Radio y Televisión. Que es la que atiende los medios de comunicación en Cuba.
We also work closely with the Cuban Institute of Radio and Television, which is works with the Cuban media.
Para buscar más sensibilidad sobre el tema.
To look for a greater receptiveness or sensibility towards this question.
Y apoyo incluso en cada una de las áreas y organizaciones también.
And providing support in the different areas.
En la Casa de África en La Habana.
We have the Casa de Africa in Havana, that's Africa House.
Desarrollamos incluso muchos diálogos y foros.
Which has many dialogue conversations and forums.
También con visitantes incluso que vienen del propio África.
Including many visitors who come from Africa to participate.
Y estos temas incluso de la cultura africana, por supuesto, es un tema que nos atañe.
And of course, the question of African culture is one that touches us very deeply.
Tienen que ver con nuestras raíces.
It has to do with our roots.
En Cuba hay un dicho que no tiene Congo, tiene de Carabalí.
There's a saying in Cuba, which, if I can translate it, is in Cuba there's no one that's, if you don't have a little bit of Congo, you have a little bit of Carabalí.
No somos puros, somos también mestizos.
We're not just pure, we're mestizos.
Por tanto, es un tema que nos compete a todos y a todas.
So it's a question that affects everyone.
Y con fuerza incluso participamos en foros internacionales en España.
And
incluso
we participate in a very energetic way in international forums in Spain and other places.
Para mostrar nuestra experiencia, incluso una de las universidades de Miami está invitando a integrantes de esta comisión. Sí, una universidad de Miami está invitando integrantes de la comisión.
The University of Miami has invited members of this commission.
Para también mostrar nuestra experiencia desde la propia Unión de Escritores y Artistas.
To show our experience through the experience of the Union of Writers and Artists.
Esta comisión no solamente la integran artistas, sino también estudiosos, filósofos, que no son miembros, pero que también contribuyen a a este trabajo.
And this commission is made up not only of artists and writers, but also academics, philosophers, and others who are not not members, but who contribute to this discussion.
O sea, que es un tema que sistemáticamente estamos trabajando en cada uno de nuestros espacios. De la Unión de Escritores Artistas.
It's a question that we're taking up in every one of the areas of
y de ahí también
the work of our organization.
De ahí también salen textos, libros.
And that has led to us publishing books and other publications.
Documentos, eso que todos tienen acceso.
Documents that are made available to everyone.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Before entertaining any other questions, Chair would like to entertain a motion that the People's Organization for Progress supports furtherance of the normalization of relationships with Cuba on the basis of removing Cuba from the terrorist list, ending the blockade, return of Guantanamo to its station, dialogue on the basis of mutual respect of independent social system and sovereignty. Daniel, you still moving?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second
by Brother Zaid. Is there a discussion of the motion? Hearing no discussion, all those in favor signify with an aye.
Aye!
Viva Cuba!
Viva Cuba!
Brother, I want to say something.
Please.
If you were. Hi. Let me introduce myself. I'm Ariel Hernandez, First Secretary of Cuban Mission to the United Nations. I would like to add two or three sentences. I would like to remark some issues. This is very important. Listen, this negotiation is the first time that U.S. government recognize and negotiate, officially recognize the Cuba Revolutionary Government. That's the first time during our revolution. That's why this is our victory. This victory is your victory too. You know why? Because this part of conversation, this is the first time that US government not input any condition for sit and negotiate. This victory is for us, for all of you too. But at the same time, we need to be clear. The US government said that the blockade didn't work, right? But they keep the same goal. The goal is change the regime in Cuba. That's why, as said my comrades, we need to keep alert in this fight, in this battle. So, why is the U.S. government intention? Financial, supporting, and supply any, whatever, to the Cuban counter-revolution. You know so well in this state, New Jersey, there are a lot of forces and groups who work against Cuba. We don't need to express exactly what mentioned. But the Cuban revolution are sure that people and organizations like you, who support the Cuban Revolution, are able to fight together us in order to alert them to fight, to facing these forces. That's why for us it's a pleasure. We are so proud to share in the same place, in the same position, in favor of the left movement. Thanks a lot.
Carol, who else? Let me get the stack going here. I'm an equal. Sister here. 1, 2, 3, and then Daniel, 4.
Questions? All right, you've already
answered. Let's match my time, 49.
You've already answered my question about Guantanamo, and yes, we want you to have Guantanamo. And shut down the prison, shut down that horrible, horrible prison. I just want you to know that what you said about how you welcome visitors with love and friendship, I went to Cuba about a year and a half ago, December 2013. I went to study your healthcare system. And with Witness for Peace, we stayed at the Martin Luther King Center in Havana most of the time. But we did go out into the countryside. We went to your medical college. And it was just your medical system. I mean, we're jealous because some of us here are working for single-payer healthcare for all here in this country, and we know that we don't have that. We're a long way from single-payer Medicare for all, and we want to follow your example in providing healthcare for all, because that's the only way to go. It is a human right.
Yes, I would appreciate it if you would elaborate some, because too many people in this country do not realize or understand the important role that Cuba played in the liberation of Southern Africa. If it had not been for Cuban troops, apartheid might still exist in South Africa. You got to understand that. Its relationship with other Caribbean nations, some countries wouldn't even have a healthcare system. Haiti is an example without Cuban doctors. Also, I'm concerned about the health of our leader, Fidel Castro. If you speak on that.
Lázaro said that there's no other organization in the world like UNIAC, the Union of Writers and Artists in Cuba. I think the same could be said about the Federation of Cuban Women, that there's no other women's organization like the FMC, which was born out of the revolution in order to involve women in the revolution and to, together with the revolutionary government, to advance and to the economic and social and political integration of women in that. I wish you would just talk a little bit about that revolution and why it made it possible to do what no other country has done in the time that you have done it in the status of women.
Daniel,
address, and maybe you could help the United States put on the correct value for human life, because the reason why I'm saying that, how you can help America put on the correct value of human life, you have a guy named Posada who shot down an airplane that killed more than 50 people. But here you got a woman named Ashanti Shakur. Ashanti killed, they say one person. And he got that killed 50 people. And they say, no, we want Posada. No, we want Ashanti Shakur. But they ignore Posada. This guy killed more than 50 people. It doesn't equate.
Esa no es una pregunta, ¿no? No es un comentario.
Si quieren responder.
Bueno, a ver, yo voy a decir algo aquí rapidito. Sí, pero quería antes de hablar de, y a ver si con esto terminamos.
Well, they have to get back in time to get up in the morning, so maybe I think they want to do our, like, a final round. Is that okay?
Bueno, Mary, nuestra amiga Mary, Mary Alice, hablaba de las mujeres, una revolución dentro de la revolución.
Our friend Mary Alice is referring to the revolution within the revolution.
Yo creo que aquí compartíamos que si Mary distribuye el libro que hizo, se podría saber más de una revolución dentro de la revolución.
And if the book that Mary Alice helped produce was distributed more widely, people would know more about this revolution within the revolution.
Bueno, esto es una expresión de nuestro querido compañero Fidel.
This is an expression of our dear comrade Fidel.
Que en estos momentos está en perfectas condiciones.
Who right now is in perfect shape.
Compartiendo con nuestro pueblo.
Sharing with our people.
A través de sus artículos.
Through his articles.
Y hace poco recibió a los cinco en su casa.
And he recently received the five heroes at his home.
Cuando Fidel hacía referencia a una revolución, que las mujeres son una revolución dentro de la revolución.
When Fidel made the comment that women were making a revolution within the revolution.
Tenía la idea de que había que contar con las mujeres para hacer esta revolución.
He had the idea that we had to have women to be able to have this revolution.
Porque las mujeres son en estos momentos más del 50% de la población cubana.
Because women are more than 50% of the Cuban population.
Y son también el 50%, o sea, las madres de la otra mitad.
And they're 50%, they're mothers of the other half.
Es decir, si las mujeres no se hubieran involucrado en todo el proceso y los programas de la revolución.
If women hadn't been part of all the processes of the revolution.
Creo que hubiera sido imposible haber tenido la revolución que tenemos hoy en día.
I think it would have been impossible to have the revolution that we have today.
Y lo voy a unir con la otra pregunta.
And I'll combine it with the other question.
Cuando aquí se habla de África y de la ayuda cubana en África.
When we talk about Africa and Cuba's aid to Africa.
Siempre recuerdo cuando nuestro querido compañero Fidel decía que nosotros tenemos una deuda con África.
I always remember what our dear comrade Fidel always said, that we have a debt with Africa.
Porque nuestra población es una población mixta.
Because our population is a mixed population.
Es la unión de los esclavos que traían del África, o sea, que llevaban del África hacia Cuba.
It was a mixture that included those who were brought from Africa as slaves.
Con los españoles.
Combined with the Spaniards.
Y de ahí surge el criollo, el cubano.
And out of that came the criollo, the Cubans.
Es decir, tenemos nuestras raíces precisamente en el continente africano.
We have our roots in the African continent.
Y por eso él decía que teníamos una deuda con África.
And that's why Fidel said we have a debt towards Africa.
Viva Fidel.
Y que había que contribuir a esa liberación de África.
And that we had to contribute to the liberation of Africa.
Nuestro país envió a un personal especializado para apoyar esa liberación.
Our country sent a specialized trained personnel for the liberation.
Y no solo fue un personal militar.
It wasn't only military personnel.
Fue un personal también de apoyo, por ejemplo, en la educación, en la salud.
Also going to Africa were personnel that were a specialist in education and healthcare.
Porque mientras se llevaba a cabo la guerra, también se llevaban a cabo proyectos para que las personas pudieran educarse, o sea, proyectos de educación, proyectos de salud.
Because at the same time the war was being waged, we contributed to educational and healthcare projects.
Y conozco esto porque
I know about this.
Mi madre fue una de las que participó en esos eventos. en la parte educacional.
Because my mother was one of those volunteers who participated in educational program.
En Angola.
She was in Angola.
Y ahí trabajó para crear programas de educación para el pueblo angolano.
And my mother was part of the creating educational programs for the Angolan people.
Y también participaron muchísimas mujeres en todo este proceso.
And many other women participated in this process.
No solo en la parte militar, sino también en la cultura.
Not only as military combatants, but also in the field of culture.
Y creo que esto contribuyó mucho a que en la actualidad estos países del África sean libres, libres del apartheid.
And I think this really contributed to the fact that these countries are free from apartheid.
Pero seguimos en África.
But we remain in Africa.
That's right.
Estamos combatiendo el ébola.
Today we're fighting Ebola.
Y combatiendo todo tipo de enfermedades.
And all kinds of diseases.
Y estas personas que participan en esta solidaridad son personas de pueblo.
And these people who are taking part in these solidarity efforts are from the people.
Miren, había un grupo de mujeres.
Or ordinary people.
Había un grupo de mujeres en Sierra Leona y en
¿cómo se llama el otro país?
Liberia.
Y en Liberia.
De mujeres,
de sí. Mujeres brindando apoyo médico.
There's been a group of Cuban women as part of the healthcare support in Sierra Leone and Liberia.
Cuando surge la enfermedad.
That were there when the epidemic broke out.
Algunas de ellas fueron para Cuba de vacaciones.
Some came back to Cuba for their vacation.
En ese momento que se abre, se destapa la enfermedad.
Where the disease, you know, broke out, where it became a massive problem.
Y la decisión de estas mujeres que estaban de vacaciones, se les explicó que la enfermedad era muy peligrosa.
And these women made a decision. They were back in Cuba on vacation. It was explained to them this is a very dangerous disease.
Y la posición de ellas fue regresar junto a sus compañeras.
And their response was, their decision was to return together with their compañeras.
Y apoyar en lo que fuera necesario para combatir esta nueva enfermedad.
And to support in whatever way possible the fight against this disease.
Y ahí estuvieron.
And there.
Estuvieron hasta que llegaron los relevos de ellas.
And they stayed there until their relief arrived.
O sea, ese grupo de médicos cubanos, en este caso hombres, que partió hacia estos dos países para combatir la enfermedad.
That is, they were then relieved by the group of doctors, male doctors, who came to work in these countries to fight the Ebola.
Es decir, que nuestro apoyo a este continente es incondicional.
And that is to say, our support to this continent is unconditional.
Y creo que nuestro apoyo al mundo es incondicional.
And our support to the world is unconditional.
Okay. One. Las compañeras, sorry.
I had a long day.
No más. Okay. Can I ask one question? And thank you so much for coming. And the information that you share is really wonderful. And I just want to know, when you see, you know, we're in this country, we have these issues going on of racism and black kids and black people being unarmed and being shot down by police. What do you think when you see that from such a mixed society, and even back from early on, we know that most of the discrimination, even in Cuba, from what I know as a child, I am not Cuban, I'm an African American, but I have relatives, distant relatives who are mixed Cuban. But I want to know, what do you think when you watch the racism that we have here? Knowing that you didn't have any even hint of racism until you got the influence from this country.
Que pero qué pensamos, cómo reaccionamos.
¿Y cómo lo ven ustedes, dado que es tan diferente la realidad en Cuba?
Miren, de los que estamos aquí,
I can tell you, from those of us who are here,
los tres somos nacidos después del triunfo de la revolución.
All three of us were born after the triumph of the revolution.
Es decir, que hemos vivido en un país socialista.
That is, we've lived in a socialist country.
Y desafortunadamente hemos conocido el capitalismo cuando venimos aquí a los Estados Unidos.
And unfortunately, we've witnessed capitalism when we come to this country.
Y cuando visitamos otros países capitalistas.
And when we visit other capitalist countries as well.
Y la verdad, es muy impresionante e impactante.
And the truth is, it is very striking. It has a big impact on us.
Conocer el interior de esta sociedad.
To see the inside of this society. We were coming back from the United Nations to the Cuban mission by car.
Y vimos tres fotos.
And we saw three photos
de niños perdidos.
Of missing children.
Para nosotros es algo inusual.
That for us is extremely unusual.
No estamos acostumbrados a eso.
We're not used to that.
Y nos impresiona mucho tener que ver estas cosas.
And it has a real effect on us to see, to witness these things.
Porque en mi país, en Cuba, en nuestro país,
because in my country, in Cuba,
los niños no desaparecen.
In our country, children don't disappear.
Los niños son
la esperanza del mundo,
children, como dijo nuestro poeta José Martí.
The children are the hope of the world, as our poet José Martí said.
Y es algo que se protege mucho en nuestro país.
And it's something that is very protected in our country.
Es un ejemplo, por ejemplo,
that's just one example.
De cómo nos impresiona, nos impacta.
Of how we are struck.
Tener que ver estas cosas.
By having to see these things.
Tener que conocer que en el mundo suceden estas cosas.
To realize that in the world these things happen.
Por eso es que defendemos tanto a nuestra revolución.
And that is why we defend so much our revolution.
Porque estas cosas no suceden.
Because those kinds of things don't happen.
Las mujeres son respetadas.
Women are respected.
Los niños son intocables.
Children are, cannot be touched.
Y, por supuesto, existen muchos retos por vencer.
There are many challenges to be overcome.
Y hay desafíos.
And there are challenges.
Pero seguimos ahí, trabajando.
We continue working.
Que es lo que nos toca a esta generación.
Which is what the job of this generation is.
Y enseñar a las que vienen.
And to teach the future generations.
Vaya, pa'lante. On behalf of the People's Organization of Progress,
I
would like to thank las compañeras and the Cuban people for the example that a better world is possible. I want to thank you for the resistance for half a century to our common enemy, U.S. imperialism, for the persistence in struggle for a better world. And we want to thank you as an organization that's rooted in the Afro-American freedom struggle. It's already been said, but it can't be said enough, that we thank you for the martyrs from Cuba who struggled for liberation of Africa. We will be forever in debt. Vaya por la revolución. And although he's late, he's never, our chairman would like to make a presentation on behalf of the People's Organization of Progress.
Quisiera hacer una pequeña entrega.
Good evening. Now to the people. Bow to the people. I have apologize for not being here earlier.
Me disculpo por no estar aquí antes.
Our organization was being recognized at an awards dinner tonight.
En una cena de premios.
And I had to go and receive the award for the People's Organization for Progress. Many of our members are at that dinner also. But I felt it was my duty, after I received the award, to sneak away and to make sure that I was here to greet you. Please send our revolutionary and fraternal greetings to the people of Cuba. They continue to inspire us. And we are so glad to see that finally, after 50 years, we are beginning the normalization of relations between our two countries. But I, as a citizen of the United States, please be on guard. Don't drop your guards.
I know. Thank you for sure.
We have a long history of dealing with this government. And we know that sometimes they give with one hand and they take with the other. About 2 weeks ago, President Obama declared that we would begin to have normalized relations. But then a week after that, he declared Venezuela to be a national threat to the security of the United States. We do not think this is an accident, and we see these two events as being connected. We support the struggle of the people of Cuba to continue their revolutionary project, and we support the people of Venezuela in their struggle against U.S. imperialism. We love the people of Cuba.
And we love you.
We love you. And we love Fidel.
We love
each other.
Viva
Fidel. And we love Che.
Viva Che.
Viva.
And whenever I think of Che, I think of what he said, that revolutionaries are motivated by true feelings of love. So on behalf of our organization, the People's Organization for Progress, we present the People's Leadership Award to the Cuban Federation of Women for your enormous example and commitment to the cause of women's liberation and revolution. Let me just say one more thing. We are going to continue to fight until the embargo against Cuba is lifted. We are going to continue to fight.
Thank you.
Until the embargo is lifted.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bueno, queremos agradecerle a la organización.
Well, we want to thank the organization.
Y este presente va a ser entregado a la Secretaria General de la Federación de Mujeres Cubanas,
will be delivered to the General Secretary of the Cuban Women's Federation,
que está con nosotras aquí en la Comisión de la Mujer,
who is with us at the United Nations Commission on the Status of Women,
que va a estar el sábado.
She will be participating on Saturday at the event in New York City.
Y esto formará parte de nuestro salón donde recibimos a las delegaciones.
And this will be put in the room that we have in our headquarters where we receive international guests.
En homenaje y en agradecimiento a esta organización.
In honor and in gratitude to this organization.
En este lugar hay muchos obsequios.
In this room we have many
entregados a nuestra presidenta Vilma Espín.
That were given to our president Vilma Espín.
Y creo que este puede ser uno también de esos presentes, creo que inolvidables.
And I think this too will be one of the unforgettable presents.
Y que formará parte de ese salón.
Which will be part of that room of honor.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Thank you for everybody coming. Cuba sí, bloqueo no. Cuba sí, bloqueo no. Cuba sí, bloqueo no. Cuba sí, bloqueo no.
Thank you.